author. And Mark Twain used to visit the laboratory all the time. There's a picture of him holding a light bulb there. There's all kind of stories. Some of them I probably won't tell, but there's all kind of crazy stories that I could tell about Mark Twain and Tesla too. But with time here, we won't go into everything. There's just so much stuff on Tesla. If you just type Nikola Tesla into the internet, you'll see there's a tremendous amount of information. There's a lot of it's almost like a Star Trek fans, okay? That there's a whole bunch of fans of Tesla and people building Tesla coils and so forth. Here he is here, showing some of his coils and things there for wireless power. 1899, he was thinking of these ideas. And then there was a very important patent that he came up with in 1900, which was basically the apparatus for the transmission of electrical energy. And it turns out that this patent in 1900 basically was on transmitting and receiving radio waves. Okay, and that's going to be very important. Because in 1904, just a few years later, the patent office surprisingly just basically reversed the patent decision, threw out his patent, and they gave Marconi the patent for the invention of radio. Okay, and probably conjecture is Marconi had a lot of investors and money and knew that there was a lot of money involved. And so somehow the money got mixed up with the government patent office and this happened. Okay. Well, of course, Tesla was really mad about something like this, that his patent would be thrown out. And Marconi was even given the Nobel Prize in 1911. And that even made Tesla even more mad. Because he knew he came up with it in 1900 and had the patent to prove it. So he tried to sue Marconi, but it takes a lot to sue a big company, because Marconi was very successful, as you know. They had the transatlantic communications. It became a big communications company. And so he, to his death, he still had the lawsuits going, but it was very difficult to sue. But right after his death, he died in 43. Pretty old age, and after his death, the Supreme Court basically went back and looked into it again, and there were some other facts in there too, with the government was trying to sue Marconi for some infringements, and it's all kind of factors, but basically the thing that came out was that they basically gave the patent back to Tesla, and so Tesla is really the inventor of radio.
Does he have any beneficiaries of that?
Yeah, I think he probably did, yeah. He actually died not a rich man. Okay? He was okay, but he wasn't super wealthy when he died. But anyway, that's an important thing that a lot of people, you know, don't know about. Okay, then he moved into Colorado Springs. This was still on trying this whole concept of getting energy wirelessly. And he built all kind of experimental stations there. And this is a very famous picture that you may have seen somewhere in books or someplace. And it turns out it's not really real, okay? It was sort of a publicity photo. They overlaid the two photos, so he wasn't really sitting there. I think he probably knew a little bit better than that to sit right under the Tesla coil. But anyway, this laboratory, it was unbelievable. He actually created arcs that were like 130 feet long. And to this day, they still maybe can't reproduce some of the stuff that he did. He lit light bulbs up within 25 miles of this place, okay? So, and he had all kind of other experiments. He not only believed you could transmit electrical energy wirelessly, he believed you could transmit the energy through the earth, and also mechanical energy, and he actually had oscillators that would shake the earth. And there's a famous story that he created an earthquake in like a 10-city block area of New York one evening, and it was actually registered on the Richter scale and everything. So he did some pretty amazing things. Here he is here trying to pump the earth, okay? And here's some incandescent lamps that he lit up. And you know, to this day, there's still a lot of things that can't really figure out how he did some of this stuff, because he didn't write a lot of notes down, and so there wasn't a lot of information about a lot of the things that he did. Then a very famous guy, J.P. Morgan, most of you have probably heard of him, had a lot of money. he got wind of Tesla and decided he wanted to put some investment in as well. And so Tesla moved back to New York, and he started building this huge system, okay, back in New York. There's an example of a huge Tesla coil there. I should continue here. But what happened is J.P. Morgan got disenchanted because he started seeing that Marconi was really, really doing good with his communication systems and everything else. And so he really didn't want to put any more money in. So a lot of the stuff never got completed. Okay, and Tesla was pretty depressed about it because he knew he could build all this stuff, but he never got a chance to finish some of the things that were done there. Well, with time here, I'm going to move on a little bit because we get to these demos as well. Just mention a little bit in later years, Tesla and some eccentric qualities that he had. Here's a picture here of him at 64, and here he is here at 79. And one of the things about Tesla is that, remember, he didn't have many friends and wasn't married, and he just worked all the time, got 2 or 3 hours sleep. But for some reason, he just had a something going on with pigeons, okay? He really loved pigeons, and he used to go to the park, and he'd find injured pigeons and bring them back, and he had all these pigeons living in his place. He lived in a hotel, a New Yorker, which was like, I guess, the Waldorf Astoria at that time. And he would bring these pigeons back to health and then let them go, and then he'd find it. He had that one there, that was his favorite, okay, the white dove. So anyway, he'd have these pigeons, that was one thing. Then I mentioned about germs, especially as he got older, and it might have something to do with his brother died at a young age, and they thought it was because of germs or something. We're not really sure. But anyway, he would just wash his hands all the time, okay? And he would only eat boiled foods. He arranged with the restaurant that there was only one table. Nobody else could eat at that table except him, okay, at the restaurant. And no tablecloth, because he believed there could be germs in the tablecloth. And then before he would eat, he'd have to see them sterilize all his silverware, okay? And so, and once they said a fly landed on the table, and he made him change all the silverware and reset the table and bring new food out just because a fly landed on the table and flew away. So he definitely had genius, but he had some eccentric qualities, which a lot of geniuses have, I guess. As I mentioned, photographs. There weren't many photographs. The reason that he didn't want photographs taken was every person has like an electromagnetic aura around them. And he believed the photographic process, someday somebody would figure out in the future how to get out, you know, maybe his ideas in that electromagnetic aura. So that's the reason he didn't want pictures to be taken, okay? Because he didn't want his ideas to appear, somehow somebody would figure that out. He also, scientific theories, some of the new theories of the time, Einstein, he didn't believe too much of that either. He was against a lot of those new theories. So, you know, he didn't have everything right, I guess. Of course, maybe Einstein doesn't have it right. Maybe Tesla really did have it right. So we have to wait and see. War, that was another thing. He didn't like war. And he said that in the future, again, this is 1922, he thought war would be fought a lot with machines. Okay, so that might come true someday. You might think about that a little bit. Here's a picture of how he envisioned war with like ray beams and all kinds of stuff going on. This is 1922, okay? And in 1931, he announced that he was on the verge of some new energy source, some new ray or something of energy. And the New York Times heard about it, and they published this in 78. Tesla Bear's new death beam, okay? Well, Tesla didn't really believe it was a death beam. He thought it would be a defense mechanism so that this beam could be used for incoming, you know, military and so forth. Well, that sort of sounds sort of interesting too, because you may have heard of something that Reagan came up with back in the 80s called Star Wars, that Strategic Defense Initiative. Sort of the same principle. And in the late 50s and 60s, the U.S. and the Soviet Union developed something called a particle beam weapons, okay? And it turns out that when Tesla died, a lot of his papers disappeared. Like, his family went in after a couple days, but somebody had already been in there, and they basically cleaned out a lot of his files. And to this date, they can't find where the files went, okay? So some people conjecture that all this particle beam stuff was really Tesla's records, okay? So, it's hard to say. There I say it right here, what happened to Tesla's scientific papers? He did have some cabinets, like I said, he tried not to write anything down, but when he did write something down, he made sure it was really locked up with multiple locks, okay? This is just a death mask. It's up in New York City. And it has what they say are his greatest inventions, the oscillation transformer, induction motor, wireless power transmission. There's also, I read that he was interviewed once in later years, and the interviewer asked him, he said, could you just list some of your major inventions, you know, tell us about your major inventions. Well, he actually said, oh, I'll do better than that. I'll tell you every one I ever did. And he went down in chronological order right from his brain and listed them word for word, okay, about 100 inventions or whatever. And so that's a true story as well. Anyway, the Tesla coil, that's what we're going to get into next here. This was something that he believed he could, you know, transmit high-frequency energy and be his wireless transmission system. There's a Tesla coil there. And won't go into all the details, but it's actually fairly simple to understand the basic system. There's some AC voltage source, and of course AC is a sine wave, has the peak plus and the peak minus on the cycles. And as the waveform's coming up, going to the positive peak, it's charging this capacitor in series with this coil. Okay, so that charges up. And then there's a spark gap. And so when the voltage gets great enough at the peak of the cycle, this spark gap will arc over and short out. When that shorts out, this then forms a series resonant circuit. And it oscillates at the resonant frequency of the L and the C for so many cycles until it dies down, and until the voltage dies down and the spark lets loose. But while it's oscillating, it couples to this secondary coil. And we'll show that over here later how that works. But if you have a very few turns in the primary and a whole ton of turns on the secondary, and you get the resonance of this circuit with the capacitance around here, the resonance of that circuit, if you get them both in resonant, you can get tremendous voltages across the circuit here. And that's where you see all the lightning sparks and streamers and everything come off. So that's the basic principle of the one type of Tesla coil. Here's some pictures of Tesla. This is pretty much in chronological order. There's not very many, as I said, but it sort of shows what he looked like. I think this one looks a little weird, but anyway, that's what he looked like. Okay, now let me. I'm just going to show quickly here a couple of movies of some Tesla coils that were built up. Okay, yeah, I think how are we doing on time here? I'll just show this one movie. I got some others, but I'm just going to show one movie. This is probably the largest Tesla coil, okay, that some amateur Tesla follower built. This is in Oklahoma, and it's very huge. Let's see if this works here. There's some music in the beginning, but later on they'll put the real sound on it. In some guy's backyard in Oklahoma. I think it'd have to be Oklahoma. You notice there's nobody standing around the box. Circles, this, and then there's a wire cage that is forming the torus at the top. There's a Tesla coil. This is a secondary. There's many, many hundreds of turns of wire going up there. And the primary is right here. It's wires wrapped around here. Okay, what I'm going to do now is turn it over to Dave, and he's going to describe a Tesla coil that he built and actually fired up here.
Okay.
Hold on, they're going to help you. Before we do this too, I do have to make an announcement. We have to make sure, is there anybody in here that's wearing a pacemaker? I'm serious, because it could upset if you are. So if you are, you might want to step out. Otherwise, we may create a little ozone, so we're going to open the windows up a little bit. It shouldn't be harmful, but you might start smelling something once these things start going.
Thank you, Jim. My name is Dave Blood. I'm really rather humbled by this opportunity to present this old Tesla coil that I built as a young child. Actually, I built with it at age 14 in 1951. And that's 55 years ago. Now with a little math, you know how old I am. So it's 55 years ago, out of this 150 years that we're celebrating, it was when this was built. And just like Tesla, I didn't change a thing, except I didn't have the concept to begin with. I just followed a diagram that was in a popular science book of how to build different things and do things, the radio TV manual, and followed the procedure. But historically, it's quite significant, I think. It's worth saying just a little bit about it. And, Tesla coils dated back about 55 years before 1951, so we're talking about 110 years ago that the first Tesla coils came out. Vacuum tubes did not exist until DeForest came and invented the Audion in 1907. Tesla was demonstrating his high voltage, high frequency coils in the late 1890s, and had the vision of power transmission to be able to light up the world, essentially, or light up a large area with one power supply. So a Tesla coil is a high voltage, high frequency device, and this one came with newer technology. It has vacuum tubes. In the first Tesla coils used very disruptive spark gap generators like this. Very disruptive. You'll hear when you hear it that what you need to do is make and break contacts. You need to pulse this thing in the primary, and you will develop it's a transformer that will develop the RF up to high voltages in the secondary. This is built on an oatmeal box. Shows you how simple it really was. It has two vacuum tubes, triodes, number 10 tubes, which cost, now if you try to replace one, it costs about $88 a piece. Driven with a transformer that you might find in one of the old-fashioned radios, about 500 volts. And what you're doing is actually creating a tank circuit here, plate tank circuit, with a capacitor across it, which is your resonant frequency. And then that's this coil here. The bottom coil is a tap-off of its induced RF is picked up from the plate circuit and fed back in to create an oscillation. So it's an